We're four sheets to the wind with all your esports action. You're watching The Podium. G'day gamers and welcome to The Podium, where we take a look at the biggest hits, epic takedowns and classic comebacks from across the world of esports. Blowing into the seat beside me this week is Mr. Joe Gilroy.
I'm here. I'm definitely here. Bo, Yushay, I just wanted to point out to all the people watching at home that we are actually wearing different coloured shirts. It might not show up, but this is a burgundy affair, and that's dark black. So
black like my soul.
Yeah, black like your dead heart.
Yes.
So up first, we're going to talk about the OPL before we get too depressing.
Yes. But what's not depressing is OPL this week.
That's a good segue.
Yeah, because we're looking at the result. It's second weekend, and we're seeing some unexpected results with the Bombers coming good this week.
Yeah. We're the second last week of the competition, and the Bombers are fighting for their gauntlet lives. They took on Mammoth, and maths isn't my strongest suit, but I think mathematically they have secured a spot in the gauntlet. And
he's right!
I did it! it turns out, as a result, Mammoth are now in a really precarious position. Yeah. Direwolves are locked in a berth at the Melbourne Esports Open.
Yeah, as we expected.
But Mammoth will have to fight against Legacy this coming week.
Yeah.
And if Legacy win 2-0, Mammoth are out after.
Yeah, right.
It'll be a shocker. It'll be a shock loss. But Legacy could do it. They are a fantastic team. And they've been showing a bit more form, recently. So it could happen. Let's have a look at how the Bombers put away Mammoth now.
Juice again looking for it. Gets the flash out of the Looch. However, now flick back. Will fall down. Rosie is frontlining. However, will get the hook. Very nicely done. The reset is there, however, for Chippies. And they do get the kill. Mash now taking shots from the gin. Kuda needs to start blocking these. Will be able to do so on the next one. Remind.
Yeah.
Will still be healthy enough, still has the shockwave and has Chippies to get it in there.
And that's the thing, it's a value trade. Jungle gone from Mammoth. There's no contest available, all at the cost of Rosie's Nautilus.
Yeah, certainly is. Into this pit goes Chippies, however. Now looking for some form of shockwave on the back end, but Ramayan's already dead. He will get eaten up, and that is going to be the Baron and possibly the game as two members teleport to the base.
And they are onto the Nexus. Double TP, Mash alone for 10 seconds. He can't defend.
There's absolutely no way he's going to be able to do it, and Bombers out of nowhere have got their season right back.
Yeah, so the Bombers coming good. So it's been a big leap for them because last season, bottom of the table, and now they're potentially knocking out contenders, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's come a long way.
To get a berth in the gauntlet, to get a secured berth
in
the gauntlet is huge. It's a great step up.
Did anyone expect them to do this well this season?
I don't think so.
No.
I'm sure they did.
It's interesting to look at because it's one of the clubs that's being supported by a professional sporting organisation in the Essendon Bombers. So it's interesting to see, the progress from season to season and making such improvements.
Not even season to season, split to split, right?
Yeah.
That's huge. That's massive. And it is awesome. But I think, once again, we've said it all split long. It speaks to the competitiveness of the OPL this season. Obviously, the Direwolves went undefeated. They are a crazy strong team.
Yeah.
But below the third, anyone could get it, right? It is crazy.
Well, you were at the Direwolves training facility today.
I was.
You can see why they're so good.
Yeah, they've got they're doing maths. It's good stuff.
So moving right along, the ESL's back on with that second week. And it's like some of the contests you saw over the weekend.
I love the what they're putting on with the ESL AUNZ championship. But we got to see Greyhound came in, take on Ground Zeroes. And Ground Zeroes managed the upset. Greyhound are obviously one of the best teams in Australia. Ground Zeroes, up and comers. And they put together a pretty good win. I mean, it got close in the ends. Greyhound were starting to find their form again, but they've been on a pretty long road trip on tour, so maybe they're a bit off form because of that. Doesn't matter. Ground Zero got the win.
Yeah,
it's pretty cool. Let's
still
have a
counts.
Look.
Cast has been spotted out though by Extinct. It's a 1-for-1 trade. Dexter goes down as well. Great work from Extinct. Huge in the grand scheme of things. Because now it's 15-14, but a player deficit
for Greyhound, and they don't really have much map control either. Sure, they've got mid, but what are they going to do with it?
Ooh, Grat needs to be careful here as well. Extinct is in window right next to him and Infrequent in Kyoto. The superstars of the last couple of rounds, Infrequent especially, over here on this P-bomb site. But Infrequent, while he will get one, he gets traded. Moltar needs to get this frag, and Kyoto, if he wins this, that could be the round of the game. All done. It's such a long and awkward fight. 5 HP for Moltar, and still Kyoto can't hit it. Grat's getting work done. In the meantime, Kyoto, surely you've got to find something at this point. Finally, low HP in Kyoto. We'll eventually just about close it.
Yeah, and there you go. And as you were saying, it's good to see some new blood coming through as well.
Yeah, I mean, there are some classic players on that Ground Zero team, but nevertheless, they are putting it together really well. They're taking it to some awesome teams. And I think it's a great, I guess, preview of what we're going to see. One of the reasons I'm so into CSGO at the moment is I'm all Melbourne Esports Open. It's just around the corner. And the BenQ Zowie Extremes Land qualifiers were
such a catchy name.
so easy to say. They've been moved to the Melbourne Esports Open, which means we will get to see some awesome teams competing in Melbourne for the best, including Greyhound.
Yeah.
But it's a good preview for some of the other teams we might see show up at LAN and take it to the best in Australia.
Yeah, no, it's exciting. It's just around the corner too.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. So taking a look at another league, which is not only in its full swing, toward the end of its swing.
Oh, true.
Overwatch Contenders.
Yeah, the playoffs are on for the Australian Contenders season. And obviously the top four will get to compete at the Melbourne Esports Open. Yep. Hey, there's a theme. We've already seen two of the teams who've qualified, one being the Sydney Drop Bears, who are, I guess, strong favourites to take it all out. They went undefeated throughout the regular season. They dropped a map in the first round of playoffs against Serenity, which is crazy.
Unheard of.
Yeah, but the other teams playing were Kanga Esports and Legacy, and Kanga just put a clinic on. Yeah. I nearly swore. let's have a look at, I think it was Roro on Genji, just shredding through Legacy.
But this sets up things quite nicely for Kanga Esports. They've got all their ultimates coming up in just a second. Chrono's going to engage with that Primal Rage. Roro will follow up with Dragonblade
available, as you said. Comes through, Tails down, Sephira down. Big plays, Caramel Koala picked up as well. And Kanga Esports are steamrolling over all of the trees here, Jordan. Yeah, one after the other. They've literally plowed through and they've all been destroyed.
It's not even close, is it, at the moment? There's going to be a contest, of course, from Legacy, but it'll be a trickle. Changed up the composition just a little bit. Dench is going to go straight onto the May, and we're at desperate times, calling for desperate measures right now for Legacy, because they are losing this map and they cannot be affording to do that right now. They're down 2-0. This is their last chance to stay alive in playoffs and secure a place at MEO, and it just looks impossible.
Yeah, so there you go. So some really great contests coming out of this league, and it's all culminating in the Melbourne Esports Open. So yeah, for a new entity like that, there's a lot of great contests which are going to be going on when it happens in a couple of weeks.
It's all local teams too. Yeah. It's all local Aussie teams like taking one another on in local leagues, and I think it's a really good showcase of Aussie talent. I hope everyone comes out. I hope people come out to see Aussie players, you know, do battle. I mean, it's one thing to come out and support Aussie teams when they take on, I don't know, teams from around the world, but showing up for local competition, it's so important, and it's going to do awesome things.
Yeah, it'll be a fantastic showcase of the local industry. So, and it's good to see the contests that we're seeing in the lead up, because it's, you know, helping
build hype.
Build hype, but also it's like, this is going to be a great weekend.
Oh yeah.
You know, we're all looking forward to it, but like seeing these kind of contests in the lead up, like this is going to be something special.
Yeah, absolutely. And the stuff that's on the line, what's on the line for a lot of these teams is going to make it that much more, I don't know, impressive.
Yeah.
For everyone watching from, you know, live from Rod Laver and
Australia's second favorite esports city.
I know it is. It, you know, good on you, Melbourne.
You're giving it a
your
try.
Little plug. It's going to be real interesting when Sydney Devils and Sydney Drop Bears win everything at the Melbourne Esports Open.
But, you know, it's not about the Sydney-Melbourne rivalry. It's about the best situation for Australian esports. That's why we support Melbourne.
That's a good point, Bo.
So heading overseas now from Australian shores to see Australian teams in Paris playing some Rainbow Six.
Yeah, so formerly Mind Freak, now Fnatic, are competing for Australia at the Six Major Paris. Six Paris Major? whatever. And yeah, they're hoping to do that, like do it all, to take on the best in the world. I mean, that's what regularly happens at majors, I guess.
Yeah.
One of the things that happened was ninjas in Paris. Ninjas in pajamas.
It's an amazing name. Yeah. Not as good as the Sydney Drop Bears, but it's
true,
up there.
True. Yeah, they took on Fnatic first. NIP destroyed them.
Yeah.
But they're, you know, it wasn't all bad. Aces showed up spectacularly with an ace. Let's have a look at it now.
Garage Ace is flashed. He's got the LMG played up, and you'll just see all the utility from PZD will be dumped in. But Aces gets one. Psycho is aware that there's one playing on stairs. Julia will take out Neofighter. Plant going down somewhat successfully, but no, Aces sees him. Aces coming in. Can he get it? Two big kills from Aces. He sees another. A third Aces. Oh my goodness. In a 1v1. Ew, he's still got the diffuser to work through. Julia will now watch. And who's going to prevail in this fight? A Sledge versus the Maestro. Any intel from Fnatic right now could possibly be going. But look at this. One frag grenade remaining from Julio, and he's priming it on the diffuser. He'll toss it out, and Aces, will he live? He'll get off the plant. The Maestro will shoot away at the walls, but this is a bad position, but Aces, oh my god, how does this happen? Oh my word, Aces, a huge clutch, and he'll get the diffuser. Fnatic, my god. What a round!
What a round!
Well, at least go down swinging, right?
Right. Like, I'm sure. I'm surprised they didn't tilt after that. That was the first map, and I would have thrown a keyboard. I just like, screw it. I'm done. I've quit video games.
Yeah.
The world at the end was crazy.
And hence why you and I are here critiquing the league and not competing in Paris.
That's true.
But you know, as I say, they don't build statues to critics. it's still a fantastic result, right?
Yeah, it is. Hopefully they can get some momentum out of it, carry it through. It's happening right now. Everything's happening right now. But hopefully they can power through the group stages and get to the playoffs. That's the most important thing. There they'll get to, you know, show off for the world.
Yeah, and we're really excited what we're seeing from the Rainbow Six Siege community in general. So, tune in this week and make sure you support the Aussie teams over there as well. So there you have it, another great week of esports from across the region and across the globe. But before we see what else is coming up this week, you did have something that you wanted to correct from our last episode.
It's true. I guess, you know, you already know what to watch this week. Yeah. We've told you through the course of this show. But I do want to make a correction. I, you know, when we were talking about the Dragon Ball FighterZ competition from last week, I pronounced Goichi's name, Go-1. It's Goichi. I want to thank everyone who pointed that out to me. I guess that's why we stick with Australian esports. I actually do.
Is that why?
I actually do. I'm actually super grateful to the people who pointed it out for me. There's only one way to learn, right?
Yeah, no, absolutely. You know, we've got to level up somehow. We love input from the community. So if there's things that we're saying wrong, if you don't like what we're wearing, or there's things you would like us to cover on the podium, comment, let us know.
Hit us up. It did make me wonder, you know, where do you stand, Bo, on the concept of players using nicknames as their primary, moniker when they're becoming esports athletes? Do you think, you know, everyone should go by a nickname, or should they go by their full name? What do you think?
Oh, I think it's up to the individual. I think, have fun with it. There's like, you know, not the fun police here. I think like, if that's what you want to go by, like if that's what you're known as, you know, you know, your real name is, Christopher, but you prefer to be called Job. No, so I think if that's what you're known as, or that's what you want to be called by, you know, go with it. You know, it's like if Kobe had Black Mamba on his jersey, I think most people would be cool with that.
Metal World Peace?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But
maybe a bit different.
But in those leagues, you know, they do have, you know, like the NBA in particular, that's why I reference them, do, you know, they change the names of the teams, you know, for different, you know, rounds, like the Spanish round, the Hispanic round, I think it's called.
Yeah.
Correct me on that one too, if you like. So why not players, you know, go with your nicknames? I'm all down with it. Yeah,
that's awesome. I've seen a bunch of people say that, you know, for esports to be taken seriously, we need to get to a point where we're referring to players as their real names. But I'm with you, Bo. I think people should be able to, like, especially in a world where, you know, Twitch is so important and YouTube is so important and stuff like that. I think building a brand is as critical as being fantastic at these games. Oh, well, being fantastic is probably a bit more important. But at some point, building a brand is 100%. just as important.
And I think it's kind of aligned with an argument we won't get into now, but like with the Olympics thing, esports players don't need validation from mainstream media. And again, looking at the NBA, they're trying to do what esports are doing by, you know, putting Twitter handles on jerseys and putting in nicknames and stuff. So I think you should embrace it and lead from the front. Like, forget like validation from mainstream media. We've got 11 million people tuning in to the Overwatch final recently. Yeah. I think it might have been more than that.
Probably.
Yeah. I don't think we need validation from those sectors. If you want to put nicknames, I think go for it. Like you said, it's your brand. Own it.
Totally. And on the NBA Twitter handles, which of Kevin Durant's Twitter handles do they use?
All three, just to keep it real, yo. So keeping it real every week is Job Money and Boney Bones over here. Sorry, I couldn't think of a nickname on the spot.
Boney Bones.
That's good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So tune in to hear us pontificate on other such world conundrums every week here on the podium. See you then.